Hey, what is up guys, it's Okram1993 here, and today's video is going to be a spoiler video about the most important circuit break cards that has been revealed. So let's get started and I hope you enjoy it. I just want to show you some cards that we'll have in this booster pack, and let's start with the Duck Dropper, a really nice artwork as you can see. Duck Dropper, Water Wing Beast Gemini Effect Monster, level 100. This card is treated as a normal monster, as all of the other Gemini monsters. While this card is a normal monster on the field, you can normal summon it to have it become an effect monster with these effects. Cannot be targeted by or destroyed by card effects. If an opponent's monster attacks, it must attack directly. So really peculiar card here. Then we got the Dragonoid Generator, and it is a continuous spell card. Activate this card by paying 1000 life points. You can use this effect up to twice per turn. During your main phase, you can activate this effect. You cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of this turn. Also, special summon one Dragonoid token, machine type, Hearth, level 1, attack 300, defense 300, in attack position. And your opponent must special summon one Dragonoid token in attack position during this turn's end phase. Then we got the Accumulator, Light Thunder Effect, level 100. This card gains 300 attack for each Link Arrow belonging to Link monsters on the field. So, a really nice card, similar to the Calculator. Then we got the Link in Flyer, Wind Cyber's Effect, level 2. You can only special summon one card with this name once per turn. You can special summon this card from your hand to a link monster's link point on your field. Then we got the Security Block, spell quick play, target one Cyber's monster on the field. That monster cannot be destroyed by battle, also neither player takes battle damage. These changes last until the end of this turn. And then the Cyber's Beacon, trap, normal trap, you can only activate this card once per turn. If you took battle damage or effect damage from an opponent's card effect this turn, add one level 4 or lower Cyber's monster from your deck to your hand. Then we got this new Link monster. It's the X-Crawler Qualiarc, Hearth Insect Link effect, Link 2 with 2000 of attack. It requires 2 Crawler monsters. Apply these effects depending on the number of crawler monsters you control. 2 or more monsters you control gain 300 of attack and defense. 4 or more, your opponent cannot activate cards or effects in the battle phase. 6 or more, monsters you control can attack directly. Really, really nice. If this face-up card leaves the field by an opponent's card effect, or if it's destroyed by battle, you can target 2 crawler monsters with different names in your graveyard, special summon them in face down defense position. So this card is really, really weird in my advice. If you can accomplish this to have 6 or more monsters, all of your monsters can attack directly, which is awesome, but we will see if we will have some new combo for this. Then we got this Union monster. It is the Conjoined Bird Rendering, Dark Dragon Union Effect, level 3. Once per turn, you can activate one of these effects. Target one face-up monster you control, equip this card to that target, and equip this card and special summon it. So the same as the other Union monsters. If a monster equipped with this card will be destroyed by battle card effect, destroy this card instead. The original attack of a monster equipped with this card becomes 1000. Also, you can make a second attack during each battle phase. So, really nice artwork with my advice. Then we got the Altergeist Prime Banshee, another Link monster. Link 3 Dark Spellcaster type with 2100 of attack. And it requires 2 plus Altergeist monster. You can only use these effects once per turn during either player's main phase, and this is a quick effect, of course. You can tribute one Altergeist monster, except this card, special summon one Altergeist monster from your deck at this card's link point. If this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, you can target one Altergeist card in your graveyard, add that card to your hand. Then the next one is the one-time passcode, a really really nice and important card, and let's see why. One-time passcode, normal spell, special summon one, security token, cyber slide, level 4, with huge stats in defense position. You can only activate one-time passcode per turn. So why this card is important? Because you can special summon a token, but this token is cyber's type, so it would be the first card ever that allows you to special summon a token which is cyber's type. So I think that this card will be really really important also for summoning some special link monsters. Then we got the link bumper, which is really amazing. We got the pinball bumpers in here, and it's a link 2 herf cyber's type link effect monster with 1400 of attack. Link markers top left, 2 cyber's monsters. Once per turn, if a monster you control at this card's link point attacks an opponent's link monster at the end of the damage step, you can activate this effect. For each link monster you currently control other than this card, that monster gains one additional attack on your opponent's link monster during this battle phase. During the turn you activate this effect, your monsters cannot attack except that monster. So also here we got a pretty hard work. Then the next one is Trickstars with Devil. So Trickstars are a really nice archetype in my advice, and they are really able to burn the opponent, just burning damage, and it's really nice. I already saw some nice combos that can do. And it's with Devil, it's a Link 2 Light Fairy type Link effect monster, 2000 of attack, links on the left and on the right. It requires 2 Trickstar monsters. Each time a monster at this card's link point is destroyed by battle card effect and sent to the graveyard, inflict 200 damage to your opponent. Each time a Trickstar monster effect inflicts damage to your opponent, all face-up monsters your opponent currently controls loses 200 of attack for each monster at this card's link point until the end of this turn. So you can add some, you can have some additional burn damage with this card. It goes really well together with the synergy of the deck. Then we got the Blasting Wire. It is a new trap card based on the premise of Blasting Fuse appears. So this is about the columns. These normal trap cards say activate this face down card by targeting one card in this card's column, destroy it. So Blasting Fuse, it was a really nice card, but no one was able to use it because before of the link era, we just used to put the monsters in a random monster zone. But now with the link monsters, we have to choose where to put our monsters. So a card like Blasting Wire can be a really nice touch card. Then we got the Gouki Headbutt Butt. One of the Gouki, we have a lot of them. It's a level 2 herf warrior type effect monster. You can only use this effect once per turn. If this card is in your hand, you can send one other Gouki monster from your hand to the graveyard, then target one Gouki monster you control, special summon this card in defense position, and if you do, that target gains 800 of attack until the end of this turn. If this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, you can add one Gouki card from your deck to your hand, except Gouki Headbutt Butt. Then we got the Fire King Avatar Ganesha. So nice, so a new support for the Fire Kings. It's a level 4 Fire Beast Warrior type effect monster. These are the stats, and you can only use this effect once per turn. When a monster effect is activated, if you control this card, it is a quick effect, you can negate that activation, and if you do, destroy one fire monster in your hand or that you control other than this card. If this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard, you can target one Fire Beast Warrior Winged Beast monster in your graveyard other than this card, special summon it, but its effects negated, and if any, also destroy it during the end phase. So quite quite nice support for this archetype. And then the last one is another Gouki, the Thunder Ogre. It's a Link monster, Link 3, Earth Warrior type. Link 3, as I said before, top, bottom left and bottom right arrows. It requires two plus Gouki monsters. Apply the following effect to the turn player. During your main phase, you can normal summon one monster at this card's Link point in addition to your normal summon set. So this is really, really nice in the Link era, really important. A monster at this card's Link point is destroyed by battle card effect, you can have this card gain 400 of attack. So that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this small or maybe long, I don't know, spoiler video. If you got some suggestions, please comment down below, leave a like and subscribe to the channel to support me. Let me know in the comments down below what do you think about this booster pack, and see you in the next one. Peace.